is brought to you by QTV, the channel for decision makers, and IndoIndians.com, the Indian portal for Indonesia. IndoIndians.com is also supporting Yayasan Tanam Pohon Indonesia. And today we have as guests Hitesh and Anil, who've been telling us all about their activities in Indonesia, planting trees, as well as their 1 million tree project. Hitesh and Anil, tell us more about your 1 million tree project, because that seems like such an ambitious project, especially when you tell me that you're going to plant 1 million trees on one day.
Yeah, in fact, when we were talking about this project in Sentul and before that at Megamendung, Hitesh always had a vision. He said, we're talking about doing smaller projects, but how about, having a vision? I said, okay, what could be the vision? He said, how about planting 1 million trees? But the first time when we had not even done 4,000, 1 million seemed very, very big.
A huge number, yeah.
But then as we did the 4,000 and then we went on to do the 18,000, now it seems that if we have enough good sponsors to back us, we do the land preparation, we do all the preparation beforehand very well, even 1 million doesn't seem to be a big number. So then we started discussing it, and it so happened that I met a friend, and she mentioned to me that she knows somebody in Subang, one of the principals in one of the schools in Subang, and they are doing something similar in terms of developing nurseries in school and all, and he could be one contact person that we should be meeting up with. And I said, why don't we have a meeting immediately? So the third day we had a meeting with the principal, and it turned out to be that he was very keen on, after he listened to our 1 million tree project, he says, rather than doing it in various other parts, why don't you do it in Subang?
Okay.
I said, that's fantastic, but can we have enough land there, and can we have all the facilities of developing a nursery and all? So then we went to meet the Bupati through him. We met with the Bupati and we met with the other governmental officials. We also met the 12 branches of the school in Subang. We met with all the school heads. And it turned out to be that they were all interested in doing this 1 million tree project, and they would be helping us in developing the nursery, doing the land preparation, and in fact also doing the plantation. The students would be doing it together with the community and their parents, the students. So it was a fantastic concept.
So the schools already had their nurseries in place, or is this something that you're helping them create?
In some of the branches, they had a smaller size nursery. We've given them some facilities to develop it into a bigger scale. And then we are supplying them with poly bags. We are giving them some money to buy the planting medium and the other stuff. They are collecting the seeds. Now, the species that we have decided in Subang has been decided after we have consulted the community and the school.
So it's trees that the community wants in Subang.
Exactly. So it's not something that somebody from Jakarta is trying to force upon them, but it is they who have decided that they want to have these Nangka and Assam Java trees.
I see.
Now, these are two species which can give them some produce, and they can either use it for themselves or they can actually sell them and generate some income for the community or the school. Now, the Yayasan is very clear with them that we do not want to get anything back from them. They can form their own cooperative or however they want to do it, collect the produce and then sell it, get the money and use it for their own benefits.
And where are you planting these trees in Subang? This would be the village land.
Yeah, part is it belongs to the Kapala Desa. So through the Bupati and the Kapala Desa, we are talking to them, identifying the pieces of land. But there are certain parts that we have said that we would also like to do it in degraded land, which is the Lahan Kritis. So they've already identified, they've given us the GPS coordinates. Next week, we have a team of people going to Subang to actually verify whether the GPS coordinates that they've given us, are they the actual pieces of land which are vacant, and the who owns that piece of land. So all that verification will be done. And that's when we will go ahead and actually identify the pieces of land where we will do the plantation.
And then to actually put 1 million trees in place would be very geographically distributed.
Yeah, it's spread all over Subang. That's the idea, to get the whole of the community to be involved in the project. So they take the ownership as well, because we want them to keep the trees alive for more than 40 years. Because if you don't work with the community, there is no guarantee that the trees are going to remain for more than 1 month.
You also have an agreement with the Bupati and the
We have already drafted a MOU. It's there with the Bupati. We have a MOU which has gone to the principal of the schools. We are going to do it all legally. And once we have the signatures from the principal, it's going to be notarized. So we are going to do it in a proper way.
So in case the sponsors want to be involved in such a activity with you at Subang, what kind of activity or involvement are you looking at?
Well, the first thing that they could definitely do is to sponsor trees. So they could say that as a corporate sponsor through their CSR activities or whatever, they would like to support this project. So they would give in X million rupees or whatever. So one is that. Second is that their people could join us in actually doing the plantation. So
okay.
People from various corporates, say for example, one of the banks would like to send 50 or 100 employees to actually do a CSR activity where they want to get their people to go and dirty their hands and plant trees. That's an opportunity for them to come with us and actually do the plantation.
I see. And what about auditing? What trees are in the ground? Because a million trees, to count a million trees over a geographically diverse dispersed area.
Well, that's one of the aspects of the MOU where we have said that we will be planting 1 million trees. But as a buffer, we are keeping nearly 20% extra trees.
Oh, another 200,000.
Another 200,000 trees. So technically, we'll be planting 1.2 million trees. So even if there is some pilferage, we feel that somebody might have not planted or something might have gone wrong and we still have less number of trees, but we will still go with the target of 1 million trees. We have certain things that we have put down in the MOU, which is like counting the poly bags or counting the bamboo sticks, the ajir, and manual verification and stuff. So we'll figure out some way of reporting back to the sponsors as to how many million trees were actually there on ground.
There is also a big possibility of hiring an independent verification authority.
Okay.
Because when the forestry department, when they do their own plantation, the government likes to see that the budget is well spent. And they often hire third party verification agencies. And we are right now talking to the forestry people and finding out more details on this. But we are sure that all the sponsors will be satisfied that the job has been done and well done. To make it more systematic, we are also breaking the project into two parts. We are doing a pilot run in January, mm-hmm. where we'll plant 100,000 trees. And the main project of 1.1 million will happen in September, October next year.
I see. So you're first going to test the systems
exactly.
and how it all
absolutely,
works
absolutely.
Before you get done.
Yes.
Sounds like a great plan. There are a lot of other people who have bought into the Yayasan. I believe Yayasan will also be represented at the ANEC in Surabaya in March.
That is right. ANEC it stands for Annual National Empowerment Congress. It's held by a company called Total Quality. It's into motivational training and all that. And we expect 5,000 participants along with some 500 directors, owners and commissioners attending the event. And they have been kind enough to give Yayasan an opportunity to speak to these 5,000 people and these 500 directors and talk to them about the climate change and its impact, our 1 million tree project, and also some opportunity to raise funds at the event.
So viewers, if you'd like to be involved in the 1 million tree project, log on to www.1milliontrees.org, or you could also log in to indoindians.com, where you can find links and more information on tree planting.